Cavs versus Wizards, who you got?
This is a game that, like, the Cavs really need to win. Mm-hmm. And the Wizards, you know how they always look at the Cavs. Like, the Wizards really want to beat the Cavs every time they play the Cavs.
Yeah.
Because John Wall looks at this team like, yo, like, I want to be in your position. We want this game. But I think this is a game that the Wizards will win.
Really?
Yeah, the Cavs are having difficulty. I think this is a game that, like, the Wizards will win.
I'm still waiting on John Wall to have that big game versus another team to where I feel like, okay, this dude is a...
Like, period in general?
I'm waiting on it in terms of thinking about like a Warriors, Spurs, Cavs type of victory. That's what I'm talking about. Not necessarily big performances in games. We know he can give you numbers. We know he's going to give you 10 assists, 20 points a game. That's just who he is. But I mean, a big win where he goes out on the floor and he is sheerly, as he says, showing no mercy.
Yo, shout out Wall. He said I'm showing no mercy, then lost. Like, long.
Shout out to Big Var.
Big Var. Shout out my man, Big Var. Yo, but Big Var is right. Like, if you come into the game, like, I want to destroy Lonzo, you've already, like, he like already has one leg up on you. Yeah, four other basketball players on the court, dog. You are worried about one man.
Yoda doing reverse mind tricks and shit on people.
For real.
Using the Jedi Force. But in this game, I'm going to actually take Cleveland. I just don't. Until the Wizards show me that they can get a big win like that, that they need. And John Wall is unstoppable, a sheer force of unstoppable will versus one of the top three, top five teams. I still got my reservations.
I don't think he shoots good enough because
I believed in him last year, and I believed in them last year, and they let me down.
I don't think he shoots good enough for you to see that. And I think the Warriors game showed you that. Like, he legit just can't shoot good. Like, if that was Russ probably still could have maybe willed him to victory because, again, Russ could shoot. With that roster, Russ maybe could have won the victory. But John Wall, dead ass, can't shoot. Like, you can look at that man from three-point range. Like, all right, you can't just look at Russ. You got to at least get a hand up. With John Wall, you can decide whether or not you want to get a hand up. John Wall literally just can't shoot that good.
Yeah, I mean, he'll eventually. He has to get it. He has to get it. That's the next step of his game to get into MVP caliber.
Yeah.
He has to be able to stretch shot. Like, that shot that he missed versus Golden State, although I wasn't expecting him to make that shot.
He shouldn't have pump faked.
No, but although I wouldn't even expect him to make the shot, those are the moments that I'm talking about. Even if he makes the shot and they lose, you made the play. You made the play. You did the best you could and you lost. It's cool. Come back. Next time you have Bradley Beal, try again. That is showing up. But he keeps having these lackluster performances when we keep saying, okay, John Wall gonna go out there and kill this person. Now, he might have played a good game versus the Kings, but it's the fucking Kings, and it's a rookie, De'Aaron Fox.
I mean, when Beal went out, I knew that was going to happen. I'm like, yo, they're going to put Klay on him, and they're going to switch him off with Klay and, like, Steph, and he's going to have no other scoring, and they were shutting down the pick and roll with fucking Gortat. And also, Scott Brooks, I don't know what the hell's wrong with him. Why did you run a pick and roll between Otto and John Wall? Also, why the fuck was John Wall on the bench so damn long? Like, you got to mix these rotations
because
up.
Because I told you Scott Brooks is not a good coach.
I might be with you.
I told you that a long time ago. Scott Brooks is not a good coach.
I'm with you. Because it's like, yo, if the pick and roll with Gortat clearly isn't working and Otto Porter is on fire, or even Oubre is on fire, what a pick and pop with one of them. Literally, he has 29 points and did not touch the ball within the past, like, the last 3 minutes besides ISOs. Gee, he's not an ISO player. Why are you doing that to him?
I'm not disagreeing.
Why are you ever calling an ISO for Otto Porter? Like, yo, that's not his game.
I've consistently said that Scott Brooks is not a good coach. And Kevin Durant, you know, kind of, even though he made the comment about Billy Donovan, I guarantee you that he felt the same way about Scott Brooks.
Probably did.
So, he not a good coach. He's just not a good coach to me. He's not the guy. Scott Brooks is Mark Jackson, but if Mark Jackson continued to get work and wanted to actually work and didn't want to be like a part-time preacher and announcer more than he wanted to coach. That's literally what Scott Brooks is to me. No real true genius on X's and O's. No real true genius in terms of player development or personnel. He just consistently has teams that are very good but can never get over the hump. Because even a person like Doc, who you would argue is a terrible coach, gets his team with the Celtics, regardless of what you want to say, he got a team over the hump, and they made it to the finals twice, and they won one of them. You can't, like, with Scott Brooks, yes, he got them to the finals with OKC, but you had Russell and Kevin Durant, and you still only got one finals out of that. One finals and what? Three conference finals?
They kind
of
did start to get hurt after that.
After what?
After they went to the finals.
Yeah, but even this, when they lost after they were up 3-1 to the Warriors, they shouldn't have lost that. And I still feel like Scott Brooks could have made better.
Scott Brooks wasn't coaching that.
That was Billy Donovan?
Yeah.
How long has Billy Donovan been there? 2 years or 3 years?
Now 3 years.
Okay, sorry. I thought that was
no.
Scott Brooks.
I thought that was Scott Brooks.
My bad.
Nah, because in the next year, that's when I think Russ tore
his meniscus shit,
yeah, in the playoffs, and like Russ out the lineup, and then KD foot broke, and then like it was kind of like started getting out the lineup.
Okay, I apologize, but still, Scott Brooks.
He's not the best.
He's not a good coach to me.